This is day one of Kuari Pass trek. So, moving ahead, we'll go to Delhi. This is day 3, so we are in between Joshimath and Haridwar, so going towards Joshimath today. So our trek will start from Joshimath, not really from Joshimath, but at least 12 kilometers away from Joshimath. We are doing the breakfast here, so it's a late breakfast, it's around 9:40 a.m. So hopefully by 6:30 p.m. or something like that, we'll reach Joshimath. Hi guys, so we have reached Joshimath today. We are staying at this hotel. So this is arranged by the trekking company that we have hired. This is probably the day one, real day one of the trek. So as you can see behind me here, these are the mountains I can see from Joshimath. What I'm waiting for here today is a little bit of sunrise shot during the snow-covered mountains on the back and the tree-lined mountain on the front. This will be really weird because I'm on the rooftop with all the water tanks and such, but I think we'll get some pink glow on those icy mountains, those mountains that are covered with snow. So what I'm hoping for is for the sun to rise. So I actually woke up at 5 expecting to get some glow, but the glow was not there because the clouds have cleared up during the night. So yesterday it was cloudy and I was tired also a little bit. But today it's completely clear. In hilly areas you cannot say nothing about the weather. It can be one thing at one time, another thing at another time. The one thing that I messed up is I did not realize that this is way high, and the sunrise that my app says happens at 5:30 in the AM, it does not even come up at till 7. So I have to wait all this time, and it's good actually. I can plan for the rest of the day how I am going to shoot this place. It's really cold. It's around 3 degrees. It's on the plus side, not minus. But I belong from a warm place, so it's cool for me. Hopefully it will warm up during the day, and if I start walking and trek, so till that time it's going to be cold. I'm wearing at least 3 layers now, and it's really nice and comfy now. So I believe this is more of a test of my layers, whether it works or not. I don't want to carry much, so what I'll do is I will hire a mule to carry my big bag where all the stuff is there, like the wearables, the meds and everything. Maybe not the meds, maybe something, all of these things, like, you know, you get to wear this heavy jacket and all this. I will make sure that the mule carries it, and I'll wear, let's say, 2 layers. I'll just carry my camera equipment on my back, and that should be it. So let's hope for the best. I see some light coming down there on the hills. So probably I'll start clicking now. I'll see you in a minute. Hey guys, I'm in a rest point now. The team is waiting here. So what happens is we will walk all the way on this road and somewhat trek a little bit to the village that where is the resting point. Then we'll have to start climbing from there. So the white peak, the first white peak that you see, that is Pangarchula peak, and the white forest, you might not be able to see it. It's really small on the white in the end. But right between there is a Kuari Pass, and on this side we have the Dronagiri, the first peak that you see behind this mountain. That is the Dronagiri, and I think we'll see more peaks once we go up a little. So this is day one, and I believe we have a lot to cover. Let's go. We are at camp one now. It's called Tugashi camp, and these are the hills that we can see from here. That is Dronagiri behind the tree, and we have other hills on the other side. So probably I'll check out, you know, if I can spell the names. And it's pretty cool. I have taken a photo earlier of those kind of clouds. The cloud structure has gone. I was a little bit late to do this video, but the cloud structure was something like you have cotton balls. There's a name for it, I do not remember it now, but I had that here. I took a shot like to this side. Hopefully that works out. And now we are going for a acclimatization walk after we take some tea. What I was expecting to see a clear sky to do some night photography, that's not going to happen today because we have like massive cloud formation here. I'm hoping that if we have good sunrise, then probably I'll get some light on those hills there. If you can see between those trees, those hills there.